Law enforcement officers paid tribute to the last of the miners coming out of the Upper Big Branch mine. These ambulances no longer on a rescue mission, but one of recovery. West Virginia's governor confirmed none of the missing workers would be coming home.
We did not receive the miracle that we prayed for.
25 coal miners were found dead not long after the explosion on Monday. Two workers survived. The final four bodies were recovered early Saturday morning. When the sad news spread, family members leaned on those nearby, including the Red Cross.
This has been a very heavy-hearted community holding on to a very, very fragile thread of hope. And when that thread broke, the pain was excruciating.
For days, thick black poisonous smoke filled the tunnels, causing problems for rescuers. A federal coal safety official says they walked past the missing coal miners on the first day and never saw them. Funerals are already underway. These victims were fathers, brothers, uncles, sons who went into the mine like any other day but didn't come out.
I'm gonna miss my friends and loved ones.
With the sorrow comes anger. Author Homer Hickam was raised in a West Virginia coal miner's family.
In a modern American coal mine, this should not happen.
President Barack Obama says every American should have a safe workplace. He wants a preliminary report about the cause this week. The president vows to thoroughly investigate this tragedy and demand accountability because he knows we can't bring back the men we lost. Congress plans to hold hearings on coal mine safety in direct response to the 29 miners who died. In Washington, Edward Lawrence, NBC News.